Hey Josh, thanks again for inviting me to your new series, Share Your Work. I'm Florian Mugala and here to tell you about my first ever plugin release, Nell 19. It is a vibrator with a random LFO, similar to tape wow and flutter effects, but without the tape degradation. And it's available as a free and open source VST3 64-bit plugin for Windows computers. You can download the code and the VST3 file from the plugin's GitHub and join its Discord group to discuss bugs, feature requests, or to get general information about updates and news. Links in the description. Before showing you how my plugin works, let's check out how it sounds and feels with some common use cases. Dial in some depth and frequency to add life to any material. The third parameter is used to widen the signal by applying a second randomizer for the right channel. This introduces flanging in mono, so it should either be used creatively or maybe as a preprocessor to diffuse the input for a reverb. You could even use it on the master bus, considering you are into lo-fi aesthetics, because the plugin's audio artifacts are way below the audible range. I made sure the plugin sounds just as good live as it does in the studio, but studio mode compensates all the plugin's latency, so turn it on if you are not playing or recording at the moment. In my plugin, I'm utilizing a pseudo number generator based on statistical data to generate new impulses in regular intervals, defined by the frequency parameter of the plugin. The depth parameter defines the resulting signal's gain, so that it can have any range between -1 and 1. Next up, I'm smoothing this curve by applying a rather simple low-pass filter tuned to the frequency of the random value generator to make the curve a continuous line, which is perfect for a vibrato because it prevents clicks due to sudden jumps in the playhead later. In order to use this signal as a vibrato, we have to define a feed-forward delay of any size and map our LFO's output almost to its entire size, only leaving some headroom to prevent clipping the array. Now, since we made a wave that essentially oscillated around zero, mapping it to positive values like this gives us a latency of exactly half the delay size. All audio channels normally have the same random LFO, but the more width is dialed in, the more every channel has their own LFOs. I first thought I was done there, since the effect already sounded really cool on most material at that point. But when I applied it to shoegaze rock music, it made all the heavily distorted and reverberated e-guitars sound really crunchy. So in order to drastically reduce aliasing and intermodulation, I implemented spline interpolation for the delay's reed-head, smoothing up its output. Josh asked me to talk about my favorite part of the code, which is this namespace, the certainty namespace. It is based on statistical data taken from a psychological study that was made in the 80s or in the 90s or something, and it had this really weird topic of describing the certainty that a bunch of people who took part in the survey describe a certain certainty with specific certainties, which is kinda ironic in some way. And that's why I decided to put that into my plugin. So yeah, I wrote down all the terms that took part in this survey, and then I got started. First of all, I import the binary data that I got from some GitHub page, and then I apply some functions to it. Yeah, so first of all, we prepare the certainties, which means we look at every single letter in the raw data and put a bunch of values into our array of vectors of certainties. We also normalize the values. Then we sort the certainties with this fancy function. Now I came up with a little method for deleting outliers. It only works for sorted arrays. Now the problem with the data was that the people were not very precise with the resolution of their certainty descriptions. They basically said stuff like 85% or 90% or 25%, but they never said stuff like 62.013% or something like that, which makes totally sense. But you know, when you make a randomizer with random values, you totally want the values that come through to be like have a little bit better resolution and stuff. So I upsample the certainties with Lagrange interpolation so that it's rather fancy. Now we have to limit the certainties again, because the Lagrange interpolation can sometimes go out of bounds massively. And at the end we normalize the values again, because we want to have values we can immediately work with. So yeah, one could argue that this is total nonsense, because even if the statistical data mattered, I'm screwing that up in so many different ways that in the end it's just some distribution of random values that kinda sounded cool to my ears after a lot of tweaking. But I mean, that's fine for me, it was fun to do this. And that's all that matters. I'm currently working on another vibrator plugin that has quite some innovative features. If everything will go as planned, it would be huge and even change the way sound designers, musicians, and mixing engineers think about vibrators in music production. As said before, if you want to stay tuned, join my plugins Discord, because I drop all news there. See you around.